गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन इन माय क्लास। हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन एट योर होम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर 7, एडजेक्टिव डिस्क्राइबिंग वर्ड। बिफोर गोइंग थ्रू द चैप्टर, आई वांट टू रिमाइंड यू वंस अगेन दैट यू हैव टू कमेंट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन फॉर योर अटेंडेंस। नाउ let's start our revision. An adjective is a describing word. It is used with a noun or pronoun to describe it or point out the person, animal, place or things, or tell the number or quantity of that noun. Here some points are given. An adjective often comes before the noun or pronoun it describes. First thing, an adjective often comes before noun. Here, for example, a smart dog. Here, what is noun here? Smart. Smart. The word smart is noun here. Now, next example also given. An old building. An old building. Here, what is old here? Old. Here pronoun. Now next one, an adjective can also come after the noun in the sentence. An adjective can also come after the noun in the sentence, after the noun. Here you can see Sumit's handwriting is very neat. Here what is adjective here? Neat. Next example, I am thin. Then what is adjective here? Thin. Point number 3, some pronouns act as adjectives. They express the possession or ownership. These are my, our, your, his, her, their and its. For example, her eyes are black. So here the word her act as adjective here. Next example, my bag is heavy. The word my here act as adjective. Next thing, the word used to describe or add different qualities to a noun or a pronoun is called an adjective. You have to know, it is very very important. The word used to describe or add different qualities to a noun or a pronoun is called an adjective. Okay, now come to the next page. Page number 38. Look at the following sentences. First sentence, a beautiful woman, a young soldier, a cold winter, a familiar voice. So here, my dear students, the words beautiful, young, cold and familiar denote what people or things are like. For example, the woman beautiful. The woman beautiful. Second, young. Third, cold. Fifth one, familiar. These words denote what people or things are like. These words describe the quality of the noun. Quality of the noun. So here, an adjective of quality. Here, what is adjective of quality here? An adjective of quality tells us of the quality of person, place or things. Adjective of quality answer the question that of what kind of person, place or things are. For example, now look at the following sentences. First sentence, an Indian temple. Second, a Chinese kung fu fighter. Here the word Indian and Chinese are showing the relationship of a person or a thing to a country. That an Indian temple, this temple is belong to India, an Indian temple. Now next one, a Chinese kung fu fighter means Chinese are showing the relationship of person or things to a country. They are also adjective. Indian and the word Chinese, they are also adjective. Now come to the next one. An adjective which tells us about the place or country, a person or thing, comes from or belong to it, called a proper adjective. Means an adjective which tells us about the place or country, a person or things comes from or belong to, this is called proper adjective. For example, look at the phrases given here. For example, phrases are given here: the French flag, a Japanese garden, two princes. Now come to the next page. Four mermaids, a few puppies. Here the words two and four are showing the quantities of things. And answer the question, how much? They are also adjective. Now come to the next one. Adjective of quantity. Then what is adjective of quantity here? An adjective of quantity or number tells us how many persons or animals or things are there. They can be definite. They can be called definite numerals adjective because they denote an exact number. That this is one means this is one. They denote an exact number. But some adjectives of quantity or number tell us about how many people or things are there without giving an actual number. For example, the word some soldiers. Here examples are shown on page number 39. Some soldier, a lot of books, many birds are flying, a few cups. So here, my dear students, we use the adjectives a few and many. We use adjective a few and many with a countable nouns, which can be the noun which can be count. That is called countable noun. We use the word a few and many. We use the adjective a few and many with countable nouns. Next one, we use the adjective a little and much. Adjective a little and much with uncountable noun. The noun which can be count, that is known as uncountable noun. Next thing, the adjectives a lot of, lots or plenty of, some, any are used with both countable and uncountable noun. The adjective a lot of, lots or plenty of, some, any are used with both countable and uncountable noun. They are also known as indefinite numeral. Indefinite numerals adjective, they are because they do not denote an exact number. That is why they are also known as indefinite numerals. Now come to the next page, page number 40. There are certain adjectives which refer to each one of a number. They are called distributive adjective. For example, each girl must take her turn. Here the word each refers to each one of a number. Second one, India expect every man to do his duty. every, the word every. Now next one, either pen will do, either pen will do. Neither accusation is true. So here certain words, each, every, either, neither, are adjective which refers to each one of a number. They are called distributive adjective. Now look at the sentences. These fruits are fresh. These fruits are fresh. This is mine. This pen is mine. Those flowers are roses. That car is mine. Now, the words this, these, that, those, placed before a noun, you can see here, before a noun, are called adjective, are called adjective. The words this, these, that, those, placed before a noun, you can see car, pen, fruit, flowers. So this, these, that, those placed before a noun are called adjectives. Now come to the next one, demonstrative adjective. A word which demonstrate or point out the concerned person or thing is called demonstrative adjective. Here you can see examples are shown on page number 40. I'm repeating once again about demonstrative adjective, a word which demonstrate or points out the concerned person or things is called a demonstrative adjective. And one more thing, the demonstrative adjective answer the questions. How? The word which. The word which. Look at these sentences. Sentences are given. What bird is this? Which dog did bite you? Which dog did bite you? Now come to the next page. Here you can see sentences are given. You have already seen what bird is this? Which dog did bite you? Now the adjective used with noun to ask questions are called interrogative adjective. These adjectives are the word which, what, and whose. I'm repeating once again. The adjective used with noun to ask questions are called interrogative adjective. These adjectives are which, what, and whose. Okay. Now come to the next one. Possessive adjective. The adjective which show ownership or possession are called possessive adjective. For example, these are my shoe. These are my shoe. This is our house. It is his car. Here, my dear student, the word my, our, his shows the ownership and possession that they are. These are my shoe. My means ownership. This is my shoe. This shoe is belong to me. Next one, this is our house. In the above sentences, my, our, and his are possessive adjective. In the above sentences, the word my, our, and his are possessive adjective. Now this is all about your revision of chapter 7, adjective describing word. Now we are going through the exercises. First one, A. Circle the adjectives in the following sentences. You have to circle the adjectives. Sentences are given below. First one, there is an empty room upstairs. Here, adjective is empty. You have to circle the word empty. Now the next one, it is a cold winter. Here, you have to circle the word cold. Third one, Delhi is clean and green. You have to circle the word adjective green. Now fourth one, the fruits are rotten. You have to circle the word rotten. It is adjective here. Now the fifth one, all the players are very tall. Here adjective is tall. You have to circle the word adjective tall. Sixth one, it is a beautiful rainbow. Here the word beautiful is adjective. You have to circle it. Seventh one, it is an Indian temple. Here adjective is Indian. So my dear students, this is your homework. Please fill your textbook also and do it in your notebook. Thank you so much. God bless you.